Hi, my name is Jim Durr. I'm an application and support engineer for Keysight Technologies. The purpose of this video is to demonstrate how to update the firmware on the Keysight TrueVolt DMMs without using the Windows-based firmware update utilities. As you can see, I've got displayed here the homepage for the DMMs. By selecting the technical support page, drivers, firmwares, and software, then scrolling down to the firmware link, I bring up the page from which the firmware is downloaded. I want to draw your attention to the add-on, to the links under the add-ons software and utilities. You can see we have the links for the firmware update utility, again, which is the Windows-based app. And we also have instructions for using that if you're going to go ahead and do that to update the firmware. What we are going to do is show the firmware update without using that, and we do that by selecting the link which says firmware update, in this case 2.14 for non-Windows operating systems. So I select that link, which brings up a window below asking me where to save the file. I don't want to open it, I don't want to save, I want to do a save as, because what I want to do is save it to a USB thumb drive, because it is the thumb drive that will go ahead and be transferred from the PC once the files are there onto the instrument, and then the firmware using some front panel keystrokes will then go ahead and update the firmware. So I go ahead, as you can see the name of the file is 34461A, it's a zip file. The first thing I will do is download the zip file to the thumb drive. This happens very quickly. Then by bringing up the Explorer, Windows Explorer, you can see that we have the zip file that has been downloaded onto the thumb drive. Now again, this is being shown using Windows, but for most other operating systems that have comparable Windows Explorer's types of functions, you'll do the same process as far as downloading the zip file and updating the firmware. So what I will do in this case, I will right-click on the zip. And what I want to do is extract the files. There are two files that are extracted, and I'm going to select Extract to Folder 34461A. A key thing to keep in mind here is that when you are downloading is that the firmware update file applies to four different DMMs. It applies to the 34460, 61, 65, and 70. However, the file that when updating from the USB thumb drive, you want the files within a folder that's titled 34461A. That's the file name. Regardless of the instrument model number that you are updating, the firmware will recognize which particular instrument is involved and update the firmware accordingly. But again, the file has to be named 34461A. So at this point, what I will do is I will go ahead and I will remove the thumb drive from the PC and insert it into the instrument. So once the USB file is transferred from the PC to the instrument, we'll go ahead and begin the download from the front panel. One thing I do want to point out of particular importance is you may notice that there is an open lock on the front panel display. What that indicates is this particular instrument has the instrument security option, or option SEC. Whenever doing a firmware update programmatically or from the front panel, the instrument has to be unsecured in order for that to happen. So for the purposes of this video, we have went ahead and unlocked the instrument security, allowing us to do the update. Another important something to point out is that you'll notice the error annunciator, which is on. All that is indicating is that indeed the instrument is unlocked, and for security purposes, it's a reminder to once any firmware updates are done to resecure the instrument. So again, we'll continue with the firmware update. We do that through the utility menu, which is accessed by pressing Shift, Utility, Test Admin, Firmware Update. Message comes up saying that the firmware update is going to begin. You press Yes to continue. And the message stating that the firmware update is in progress. Once the firmware has updated successfully, you'll get a message indicating as such. Again, firmware updates from the front panel without use of the Windows-based firmware update utility can be used with any operating system. Thank you for watching.